This award ceremony will be one of your final engagements. It would be remiss of us not to record this occasion without expressing our sincere gratitude to all your unstinting support over the past decade. Your interest and enthusiasm for young people is well known, and you've served very generously over the years. You've long been a champion of the cadet movement, firstly as the honorary colonel for Dyfed, and then with Dyfed in Glamorgan Army Cadet Force. You've also been a staunch supporter of the Reserve Forces and Cadets Association, attending our association briefings in Cardiff, and joining the chairman for many a council of RFCA briefings in London. I know that Colonel Nick has been hugely appreciative of your support to him personally through your sage advice and guidance on many issues during his tenure. Nothing has been too much trouble for you. We are all too conscious that Lord Lieutenants are never off duty, and the demands on your time are considerable. We therefore wish you well in retirement and hope that you will enjoy a good rest. You and Mrs. Lewis thoroughly deserve it. Thank you very much, sir.
Very good thing for me to be able to carry out this job for the last 10 years. I've enjoyed it enormously, and I've met so many wonderful people. That's the whole point, really, that you meet a lot of wonderful people who are trying to do their best and are doing a very good job. And I particularly think, as I always do on these occasions, of the valuable service provided by the adult instructors and officers, because if it wasn't for them, we couldn't run this. And I particularly think also of the point of young people undergoing training. Why? Why couldn't they just go down the pub or somewhere more interesting and actually come out at night, get trained and do parades? And I've told this story before, but I should tell it again because I think it illustrates the point exactly. A few years ago, some cadets had been to a training at the Hanford West Cadet Centre, and as they were coming out, there was a crash right outside the centre, and a car had gone into the central reservation, and fortunately the driver was not badly hurt, but he was very badly shaken. And what happened was the following. There was nobody there to tell them what to do. There were three cadets standing waiting for a bus, and one of them immediately went and saw to the casualty himself, made sure that he got out of the car, that he could move all his limbs and could do all the things he needed to do. A second one dashed back into the control center and rang for an ambulance. And a third one stopped the traffic to make sure that they could get the casualty off the road into the center. Now, nobody was giving commands. Nobody told them what to do, but they knew what to do because they'd been trained. And that's exactly the value of the work that your organization does and why it's such a terrific thing to belong to. Because you will leave it very much better equipped to face the trials and tribulations and road crashes of this life. So please don't give up, follow it. And thank you very much indeed for all the work that the instructors do and that the officers do, because it's without value, without valuation, it can't be valued. Invaluable, as they say. So thank you very much again for your kind words, and I wish my successor all the best, and you all the best in your future careers. Thank you.